Hi friends, and welcome back to another Walgreens informational video. I am here to go over how to best utilize the in-app perk for when you spend $25, you get a $5 register reward back. This is valid as of Sunday, February the 23rd, and it will end as of Saturday, February the 29th. Now, this promotion does come around every so often. Walgreens puts this in the front of the ad. You must make sure that you are purchasing $25 of product or more before tax is calculated, before manufacturer coupons are deducted, and after any Walgreens coupons / money has been deducted, such as the coupons found in the IVC booklet. These are store coupons. These coupons are also found online. They are one and the same. So you can either have the booklet scan at checkout, or you can have the coupon clipped to your card and it will apply. Any percentage off coupons that you may have, whether it is a digital percentage off coupon or a paper percentage off coupon, any threshold coupons that you may have, if it's a digital threshold coupon or a paper threshold coupon, you must make sure that after all Walgreens coupons / money has been deducted, you are still at the required spend amount, which is $25 for this in-app perk. Now with this perk, you can use points to pay and you will still get the $5 register reward back. I will go into more detail on that towards the end of the video, as it is a little tricky as how it's all working, but we'll get into that at the end of the video. Now with this perk, you can pay with a manufactured register reward and you will get back the $5 register reward. You can also pay with another store register reward and you will get back the $5 register reward. I will go into more detail on utilizing a store register reward to pay and still earning it back towards the end of this video. Now, this register reward is different from the manufacturer register rewards that we typically earn. This is actually a store register reward. And all that means is that it's going to act just like a IVC coupon, a threshold coupon, and balance rewards points. It's kind of all three rolled into one. Now, if you're wanting to use this store register reward to pay towards a spend deal, you can do so. You just have to make sure that after the register reward is deducted, you still meet the required spend amount. This goes for a spend deal on specific products or a spend deal on a booster. For example, let's say that you had a digital booster for spend 20, get 5,000 points. You can utilize the store register reward to pay towards your transaction. You just have to make sure that after it is applied, your transaction subtotal is still at $25. You can also use the store register reward towards a buy deal that's giving you points back. For example, this week we have a buy deal on the Tresemme. For when you buy two, you get 2,000 points back. They are on sale 2 for $10. We have a digital coupon as well as an insert coupon for $4 off two. That would bring you down to $6. You can use the $5 store register reward to pay. That would bring you down to $1. You can roll in 1,000 in points and you will get back your 2,000 points for purchasing the Tresemme. So again, you can use the store register reward towards a buy deal that's earning you points back. You can also use the store register reward towards a buy deal earning a register reward back. For example, Alme as well as Revlon is on promotion for when you buy two, you get a $5 register reward back. So if you picked up two of the Alme wipes, that would bring your total to $8.99 minus a $3 off two digital coupon or the insert coupon. That would bring you down to $5.99. You can then use the store $5 register reward and you will be left to pay 99 cents plus tax. And you could roll 1,000 in points to cover that, and you will get back the $5 register reward. So again, you can use the store register reward towards a buy deal that's going to give you a register reward back. You can also use the store register reward just as we do with balance reward points, picking up anything that you may be in need of or anything that's on sale that you wanted to stock up on. So it's working just like balance reward points. Therefore, you just have to make sure if you're going to be doing any spend deals, you are still meeting your spend requirement after the store register reward has been deducted. Okay, so let's talk about stacking the store register reward with the in-ad perk that's producing the store register reward. They will stack. So let's say we did our first transaction, we earn the store register reward, and now we want to do a second transaction and we want to earn a second store register reward. You can do so. Now remember, the in-app perk is a spend deal. Therefore, after the $5 store register reward has been applied, we must still be at our required spend amount of $25 in order for another $5 store register reward to print. So they do stack together. I did show you guys this in the haul that I did on Sunday. I will leave that video linked at the end of this video in case you have not checked it out. Now let's talk about your transaction order. So you're going to have the cashier ring up all of your items individually. You're going to scan the in-ad perk first. If you're going to utilize the $5 store register reward, that will be scanned second. If you're using any additional IVC coupons, that will be scanned third. And then your manufacturer coupons will be scanned. And then any register rewards that you are using will be scanned. And then at the very end, once your cashier tell you your total, you can then go ahead and roll in points. So again, in-ad perk is scanned first. The store $5 register reward is scanned. Any additional IVC coupons are scanned. Your manufacturer coupons are scanned. And then your register rewards are scanned and points are redeemed last. Now, one thing that is cool about this store register reward is that it has an online code. Now, I have not tried this out myself, but it looks like you will be able to redeem it online. If anyone has tried this out, please leave a comment below as to what you purchased and how smoothly this transaction went online. If you do decide to test it out and it's working, definitely be sure that you're going to ship to store. That way, you get free shipping. Again, I have not tried this out. If I do, I will definitely come back and report. But if anyone has, definitely leave that in the comments for us all. That way, we know exactly how it's working. Now, another great thing about this store register rewards is that you do not need a filler item to attach the register reward to in order to use it. With our manufactured register rewards, we are required to have a filler item because it is, in fact, a manufactured coupon. However, this store register reward, again, it acts like an IVC coupon, so therefore, you do not need to have a product to attach to it. Now, let's talk about stacking this in-ad perk with other paper perks. Typically, two paper perks will not stack. Example, if you have a spend 20, get 5,000 points paper Catalina, this will not stack with the in-ad perk. One will be kicked out. Typically, the one that you scan second will not go through. Now, if you have it in a digital form, spend 20, get 5,000 points, spend 15, get 3,000 points, it will stack with the in-ad perk. One thing to note, the thank you perks for like spend 15, get 3,000 points, those thank you perks are a little tricky, and typically you cannot use points to pay and get points back with those. Now, the in-ad perk will not double in a single transaction, meaning if you spend $50, you will not get two separate $5 register rewards printed. It will still only print just one. Now, to wrap this up, this in-ad perk is a little bit tricky because, again, it does read as a spend deal. However, you are able to utilize points to pay, and still get the register reward back. I think it's really odd that Walgreens does it this way. It kind of follows the same rules as a buy deal. With buy deals, you can use points to pay and get points back. With a spend deal, we would typically state you cannot use points to pay and get the points back unless you have met the spend requirement with your form of payment, which we use manufactured coupons, register rewards, and any cash out of pocket we are required to spend. So again, it is a little tricky, but just know that you can use points to pay and you will get the $5 register reward back with this in-app perk. All right, guys, so I think I covered everything. If there was anything that I missed, I will leave it in a pinned comment for you. If you have additional questions, definitely leave that in the comments for me as well. Definitely, guys, be sure that you like the video, share the video, comment down below. It definitely helps the channel. Definitely be sure that you are subscribed and you have your notifications turned on. That way you don't miss any uploads. As always, I thank you so very much. And until next time, guys, happy couponing.